Hey everybody, and welcome back to the garden. I'm Melissa Allman, and today I wanted to show you a really cool plant that I've got growing in my yard, and I bet you've seen them growing on the sides of the road. So let's go take a look at it. Now this plant right here is called Asclepias tuberosa, and it is actually classified as a milkweed, but it's so pretty, I don't consider it a weed at all. And if you see, it gets about 3 to 4 feet tall on these long stems that are herbaceous, and they do come from a perennial root. Now you can see right here that the stems are pretty hairy and they're really strong, and they have a nice green leaf, which actually, when it's up against the wilder type of background, these leaves will actually change to a bluish color. Now the Asclepias tuberosa does appreciate full sun and some regular water, and it blooms in the summertime around June, and this one in my yard has been blooming for the whole month of June and on into July now. And they do have the star-like flowers that are absolutely, they're so pretty, and they bloom in clusters at the branch tips, like you can see in this one. Now after these flowers fade, a seed pod is going to form on it, and those little silky seeds burst out and float through the air like dandelion seeds. And if you take one apart, this is what they look like in there. They're arranged at the bottom. And I'm going to save mine. I'm going to put them in the ground for next year. You can just go ahead and put the seeds in the ground. They don't mind going through the winter. Now, if you'd like to save the seeds of the Asclepias, you might want to get a little netting bag that you can put around each one of these seed pods to catch them, because they will blow away in the wind. Look how pretty it looks. And this is November. The Asclepias tuberosa is one of the best plants you can use to attract butterflies, particularly the monarchs, because their caterpillars like to eat on the foliage. Now the Asclepias, or the butterfly weed as it's better known, is native to the eastern United States. And if you want to find some, there are some in some nurseries that you can purchase, and they do have different colors. The genus will be Asclepias, but there's different varieties of species, so just pick the color that you like.
One thing I would tell you is that all parts of this plant are poisonous, so don't let your animals chew on them, and don't chew on them yourself. Don't eat the flowers. And if you would like to dig them up, it's best to maybe tie a little string around one of the stalks, kind of low to the ground, and then early in the spring, around March, go out there and find that little ribbon that you hung on it and dig it really deep. This plant has a tap root that's really long in the ground. Instead of, it's not a huge clump of roots, but it's long. So if you want to transplant it, you really have to make sure you get that root, because they're kind of hard to transplant. But if you see any, they're absolutely worth trying to get them to grow in your yard. So I would suggest one clump and then let it go ahead and go to seed, and that way you'll have more seeds. Try to catch them and put those in your garden also. But this is really a great wildflower. So I appreciate you watching, and I hope you get to dig you some up, and we'll see you next time here back at the garden.